Hi friends, and once again welcome to another episode of Works at Ravi Automobiles here in Vijayanagaram, Andhra Pradesh, India. Today we are going to solve an issue we had with a car of one of our customer, which is a Ford Icon 2008 model with over 185,000 miles on it. We have confirmed the customer's complaint on the car. The problem with the car is that at times all the lights come on the instrument panel along with the check engine lamp, and sometimes they stay on while the car is moving or they go off by themselves. But if we stop the car when the lights are on and put off the engine, then it won't start again. Also, in this situation, we have hit on the panel where the wiring harness for the DLC connector is located while we kept the ignition key on at the same time. The lights started to go off intermittently and come back. And only the usual oil indicator, oil pressure indicator light and the battery light stayed on. And if we tried to start at that time, the car would start normally. But if all the lights are on, as you are saying on the dashboard now in the video, the car would not start. And then we have connected our scanner. The results the codes we got were, as you see on the screen, it shows some U codes, and we also have some immobilizer, not immobilizer, we have codes on the instrument cluster module and the powertrain control module. And the codes that we had on the powertrain control module were, one was U0001-70, which is high-speed CAN communication bus fault backup, and it is showing as a continuous memory. And then the next one was U0155-70, missing communication with the instrument panel cluster module, and it's a continuous memory as well in the DTC. And then the third one was P1602-60, immobilizer module dash powertrain control module communication error. That's again continuous memory. And then the last one we had on the PCM code says U0073-60, which is CAN communication bus error. That's once again, it's continuous memory. So these are the codes that we have found for the powertrain control module. And then we had codes for on the instrument cluster module as well. So let me read them out to you.
The codes we have for instrument cluster module is, one is U0100-20, missing communication with the powertrain control module, which is a continuous memory. And then the next one is U2510-20, vehicle security data invalid or missing. That's again a continuous memory. And then the last one on the instrument cluster module is B1359-20, ignition run or accessory circuit fault. This is again continuous memory. So these are the three codes that we had in the instrument cluster module and the four on the powertrain control module. So let's see how we can attack this faults and rectify them. So now, as you can see, the damage on the wiring harness, which is beneath the dashboard. Those two wires beside the red wires are the two communication wires, which is, one is a CAN high and the other one is a CAN low. Those two got damaged, and whenever they are touching the body ground, that's when this happens. So I was trying to recreate the fault once again by connecting a wire and giving it body ground to the communication wires. That's when we see a change in the dashboard. As you see on the video, whenever I'm touching the wire to the body, which is a ground, giving a ground, we see lights on the dashboard lighting, and then whenever I remove the earth, it goes off. Also, I have connected the smart box, which gives us access to check the pins individually, along with the scanner connected as well. The pins I am showing you right now is one is a chassis ground, another one is a signal ground, and then CAN high, CAN low, and battery positive. So with this, whenever the wire is touched to the, or the communication wire is touched to the ground, that's when the resistance of the CAN bus changes from 60. Usually it's supposed to be 60, and whenever the wire is touching the in any ground or shorted to ground, that's when the voltmeter reading changes from 60. So that's what you see on the video. So friends, this would be the end of this video, and we have taped the wires where they got damaged, and then fixed all things back into place, and then we have cleared the codes on the scanner, and started the vehicle, went for a trial, everything was fine, and we have delivered the vehicle to the customer. And if you have liked this video, do subscribe to our channel, and give us any suggestions that we may need to improve our videos in future. Thank you so much, and you have a good day.